Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Europa Universalis 4, playing as Bosnia. We left off last episode having supported our Hungarian allies in a war against Poland, which they won, and claiming a new piece of territory for Hungary. Now, on our way home, it was only maybe a week later, Austria, our other ally, asked that we come in. They saw our badassery in the Polish war, and they said, hey, we need to bring those guys in and help us with this war against Ferrera. So we have joined the war against Ferrera, and I just noticed this, actually. Venice has been reduced to, like, this one province. I think they have another one down here, maybe. Somewhere. Yeah, there's one right there. Venice, when we started the gameplay, the Let's Play, they were this whole region here, and now they've been reduced to this, fragmentation of small little nations that we're actually at war with. So that was interesting. See, I didn't even notice they had been reduced that small. So we've staged up here on the border, and we're going to try to plan on what we can do. We're trying to complete a mission here for improving our relations with Aragon. That's going to give us some... Hello. It's going to give us 5 prestige and 25 diplomatic power. Let's see. So Ferrara, Genoa, and Savoy. And it looks like Austria has dedicated most of their forces to Savoy. Understandably so, because they've got more territory and more chances of fielding bigger armies. So we can actually move in and try to take over one of these regions. Perhaps the war goal. Unless Austria is moving there. But whatever, let's move. Let's stage in some Austrian territory and see, first of all, where Hungary goes. And then we'll move based off of where they go. Right, it looks like there's going to be an attack here. It looks like, which is going to be a mistake for these guys. They're going to be moving into the mountains and attacking this Hungarian-Montenegro combined army. And we are going to move into support, possibly. When are they going to be leaving? They'll arrive on the 13th, and they're going to arrive on the 17th, so they're going to be a little bit late. Alright, let's just move in. Let's just move in to help. Because that terrain bonus can be a killer. Might as well get as many men as we can. Smaller force in the mountains can certainly dominate a larger force. Okay. Right, so looks like now the Austrians have taken over their war goal. The Montenegro and Hungarian army are going to move down and take over Verona. We are stuck here. That's mountains as well. We can assist. Let's go and assist the Hungarians as they move. Was it Hungarians? Yeah. They're going to be attacking this army in Tyrol. See what I mean, though? They can stomp you in the mountains. That was a bad fight. How many men did we lose? Okay. We're gonna fall back a little bit so we're not engaged in any frontline combat while we recover. We can move down and try to knock out some Genoan territory. And we'll be in support of the Austrians and Alsace army, which is allied with Austria. Okay, let's move. Move down and take over Genoa, the capital. See if we can get there before the Hungarians do. Looks like we're going to be engaged with a... Was that a Genoan army? Was that a Genoese army? Let me slow this down in case we do make contact with them. It was. Genoese army. Let's see what happens. Okay. Now we have a terrain penalty because we're attacking the hills, but we have more regiments, and they had lower morale, but we're not rolling very good. We're actually rolling quite poorly. We're rolling very poorly. We could lose this battle. Okay, now we rolled way better. That should knock them down quite a bit. Oh, fuck. Okay, we rolled way better on that one. We just gotta keep it up. Make sure they don't get reinforced, hopefully. They rolled better. Man, this is close. This is a close one. Ah! God, what a horrible fight that was. We won, but that was bad. We lost half of our army. So let's, we'll hold here. We can hold, I think. Actually, you know what? I'm going to pull back because there's a five stack forming. Let's pull back. Okay, the relations with Muscovy has increased. We're going to fall back. I think they've pretty much got this war under control. We're gonna move back to our capital and recover for a little while. Because our manpower has been hit so bad, it's at a 1,200. Let's just move all the way back. And also to help protect from any possible amphibious assaults that may happen from, Genoa. They do have quite a navy going. We'll just let the war unfold over in the west, and we'll hang out in our home territory and really move up and support if we really need to. But a Hungarian and Austrian combined army is dreadful. Okay, so they accepted peace anyways. Austria accepted peace with Ferrara, so they are getting their war goal, Treviso right here. They did get that. And Savoy, who was an ally, is going to cede Vaud to Austria. Was that this whole section? This is all Austrian now. Yeah. So they lost about half their territory, I think. Okay. So now we're not involved in any wars right now. For how long, we don't know. Our mission to royal marriage with Serbia again. I do have an heir, don't I? Yes. Let's decline that for now. Try to avoid marriages with, teeny tiny countries. Do they have... Oh, they don't have a legal heir. Yeah, let's try that. Okay. Almost done with our Aragon relations improving mission. Should be another month. Truce expired with who? Oh, Mazovia. New country here. Did they, Alright, they haven't allied with Poland or anything like that. Sometimes you'll free a new nation and they'll immediately ally with who they were part of before. And it's like, what the hell did I release you for? Okay, mission's done. New mission. Naval race, protect against Tuscany. Can we protect against Tuscany yet? I don't think that we can. Naval race? No. We can't do any of that yet. Let's recall the diplomat from there. Rebel uprising, the Croatians. Four years. All right, let's see what we've got going on for technology. Once we get to level 5, we'll be able to unlock our first idea group, which I'm still thinking about what I want to do. We'll think about it once we get there. We're about halfway through both military and diplomatic technology. No cores that need to be made. Missionaries we could send out. Local autonomy. Change culture. 50 diplomatic. No. Buildings. What kind of buildings can we make here? Tax modifier. So we can make 2 buildings. What's going to be most beneficial? The trade power or the tax modifier? Probably the tax modifier. Plus 18, plus 20, plus 10. Let's put a temple there. And then... Dubrovka, I suppose. Okay, so let's see if that brings up our income any. Just a little bit would help. I've got a very poor economy right now. Now, how do I get my development up? Does anybody know? I'll have to look that up on the wiki or something. Hire mercenaries, build ships, recruit a regiment, autonomy. I'm gonna have to look that up. I'll look that up between next episodes. Or between the next episode, rather. Mission change at all? Nope. I just don't have enough money to do any of these ones. I can't build a fleet. Alright. We've got the worship of the Virgin Mary. The Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of our Lord Jesus Christ, is the Queen of Heaven and Mediator of many graces. There is no more perfect woman, and her holy motherhood grants her a seat at the right hand of God. Or does it? Recently, radical theologians have been arguing that there is no need for such intercessions. Are they right? Or is the Holy Mother Church in danger from their almost heretical utterings? May the Madonna forgive them. Gains a 1% reform desire to papal influence? Or the papal state's opinion of Bosnia changes by negative 20? So she is a special woman, but just a woman. All right, let's do this one. ...80% for the Croatian separatists. That's going up quite a bit, actually. I don't have any manpower, so I have no manpower coming in to reinforce these regiments here. I do have a free diplomat, so what can we use the diplomat for? Who should we improve relations with? We already did Muscovy. Sweden, maybe? Sweden, Bohemia. Austria, Bavaria, maybe. Saxony. Switzerland, Milan. They're allied with Tuscany. Papal State. Let's do Naples. Just because. And we'll keep the other one open for now. Temples are about 200 days to go. I am a little bit worried about the separatists popping up because they're going to pop up here and they might be quite large. And my 8 regiments aren't going to handle that unless I can get some support from the Serbians and the Montenegrins. Montenegronites? I don't know. I don't know. What's these guys going on here? They've got some wars. They're losing a war. Whoops. Let's check out what war they're involved with. Reconquest of Maras? It must be down here. Right here. Yep, so they're at war with these guys. So that's good. They're probably going to lose some territory here. Royal marriage with Montenegro? Sure. Sure. Royal marriages with Austria, Hungary, Serbia. Did Serbia have a new kid yet? Nope. So who's... What happens then? One of our nobles pops up, goes on the throne, somebody from our dynasty. Okay. But he's 19, so he has plenty of time. He has plenty of time to squirt out a kid. Temples will be done in a month. A little over a month. A little bit of a manpower recovery, 80% here. So they get separatism. Croatia will become a free nation. Nope. Not gonna let that happen. Not gonna let that happen. Two and a half years. Oh, let's look at what's going on in the world. France seems to be getting pretty big. England's... What happened to England? Did they... Oh, yeah, they had a kid, so that's all right. We thought for a second Portugal was going to go on the throne of England because they had no heir. Okay. What's the matter, buddy? What's the matter, buddy? My kitty's on the bed rolling around. Oh, hold on. My kitty's on the bed rolling around making squeaky noises. What's up, buddy? Huh? What are you doing? Yes, I know. All right. A new pope. And he's a papal state pope. Go figure. He's a papal pope. Was it a French pope? Who was the last pope? I don't remember. I think he was French. There was one of the other episodes, there was a new pope popped up. Oh, he was Milanese, wasn't he? He was from Milan? I think he was a Milanese one. Alright, how are we doing on technology? We're almost there on the national idea. That's creeping along, creeping along. All right, so the buildings are done, but I'm not really bringing up my money that much. 1.26. I have a free advisor. Oh, no, no, no. Never mind. I thought I could have a free one, but it says I have an open one. Why is his claim average? Why does he have an average claim? I thought I'd get a little bit more money from my subjects, but I guess not. Vassals 0.69. Fort maintenance is costing about as much as my army maintenance. Trade, production, vassals, taxation right now is bringing in the most money. Three, four, yeah. Need to figure out a way to get more money. More money. They're a vassal of Milan, and Milan Milan's kind of on the anti-Austria side, it looks like. Who's the emperor? There's an Austrian emperor, isn't it? Yep. It looks like Austria is going to be the next one as well. Papal influence, we don't have any at all, hardly. I can afford the forgive usury, but this takes down our interest. We don't have any loans and shit like that, so it's going to be useless. Well, I don't know. I think I'll stop the episode here. I forgot to start the watch at the time, but this says 15 minutes. But I didn't start it when I actually started the episode, so I don't really know how long we've been going. So, we will stop here, I guess. Kind of a boring episode. But if you guys want to see more, if you want to see what happens, give it a like, give it a comment, subscribe. I thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you next time.